ஸ்ரீ குருப்போ நம ஹரி ஓம். நாராயணம் நமஸ்கிருத்ய நரம் சைவ நரோத்தமம் தேவீம் சரஸ்வதீம் வியாசம் ததோ ஜயமுதீரயேத். சச்சிதானந்த ரூபாய கிருஷ்ணாய க்ளிஷ்டகாரிணே நமோ வேதாந்த வேத்யாய குரவே புத்தி சாட்சிணே. ஓம் ஸ்ரீ கணேஷ சாரதா குருப்போ நம சிவாய குரவே நம. So today we are dealing with the 8th verse. வேதத்வம் சௌம்ய தத்ஸர்வம் தத்வதஸ்ததனுக்ரஹாத் ப்ரூயுஸ்னிக்தஸ்ய சிஷ்யஸ்ய குரவோ குஹ்யமப்யுத. That is the verse. The பதச்சேத would be வேதத்வம் ஹே சௌம்ய தத் சர்வம் தத்வதஹ தத் அனுக்ரஹாத் ப்ரூயுஹு ஸ்னிக்தஸ்ய சிஷ்யஸ்ய குரவஹ குஹ்யமபி உதா. That is a பதச்சேத. The anvaya would be vetatvam saumya tat sarvam tatvatah tad anugrahat bruyuhu snigdhasya shishyasya guravah guhyamapi uta. So veta means one who is familiar with, or one who is conversant with. Tvam means you. Saumya means soft or non-aggressive. Tat, those, sarvam, all that. Tatvatah meaning in fact. Tat, there, or by Ishwaras, anugrahat, by the blessings, bruyuhu, they shall tell, snigdhasya, to the submissive, shishyasya, disciple, guravaha, the master, guhyamapi, even though it is a secret, rahasyamapi, uta, indeed. So that is the meaning of, the word meaning of this verse. Sridhara here writes, he sudha tvam vetha janasi. Then he says, Saumya. For Saumya, Sridhara writes, Sadho. So the word Sadhu here means, in the Agni Purana, Atmanam Pidayitvapi Sadhu Sukhayate Param. At one's own Pida or suffering, if someone engages in a good act for others, he is called a Sadhu. How? Hladayan Ashridan Vriksho Dukhanja Sahate Swayam. Just like a tree which takes all the sunlight unto itself and provides shade for people who are under it, so also sadhu, compromising his own happiness, he provides good to the others. So that is the first line. He saumya tum, he sadhu tum vetha, you know. How do you know? Tad anugrahat. Tad means tesham. Tesha means of those sages mentioned before, or by Ishwara's anugraha. Why would you know by Ishwara's anugraha? Because he says that in the Gita, tesham eva anukampartham ahamajnanajam tamaha nashayamyatma bhavastho jnanadipena bhasvata. Out of anugraha, out of anukampa, out of compassion for them, I tamaha nashayami, I remove the wheel of ignorance. So that is why he knows in tattvam. Sudha understands because the tamaha or avaranam has been removed by Bhagavan. What was the exact word? Nashayam yatma bhavastaha jnana deepena. By means of jnana deepam, I destroy the tamas. What is tamas? Tamas is mohandhakaram, the darkness of moham. Moham is your inability to see reality that is in front of you. That inhibition comes from ignorance of reality. So that ignorance will be removed by jnana deepam, by Bhagavan, by providing jnana deepam. Jnana deepam means a lamp which is jnanam, vivekam itself. With that, what does he do? Nashayami, I destroy. How? Atma bhavasthaha. Bhavam here means emotions or ashayam or intent. By changing the intent of the bhakta, Bhagavan removes that moham, mohandhakaram. So the word atma bhavasthaha here in the bhashyam, he says, atmanaha bhavaha, atma bhavaha. So the word atma is taken to buddhi or antakaranam. Bhavaha here is Ashayaha. Ashayaha means one's intent or one's thoughts. So residing in the heart, being seated in the heart itself, Bhagavan removes the Mohandhakaram. That is the meaning. And how does he do that? Jnana Deepena. By lighting the lamp of knowledge. How can the light of knowledge be lit in the intent of devotee? There the Bhashya he says, Viveka Pratyaya Rupena. So he gives this Viveka Pratyaya that is added to the intent of the devotee, the mind of the devotee. What is Viveka Pratyaya? The capacity to distinguish is called Vivekam. Distinguish between what? Between Asat and Sat, the reality and the unreality. When you don't have the capacity to differentiate, then all you are left with is unreality. That is what causes Mohandhakaram. By giving this Jnana Deepam, he gives you the power to distinguish what is Sat and what is Asat. Further, he writes, when you call this power to understand or the power to get out of this Mohandhakaram is Jnana Deepam, naturally the Deepam requires some kind of oil. That Bhagavan calls, the Bhashyakara calls, Bhakti Prasada Sneha Abhishiktena. The lamp which is filled with the oil of Bhakti and Prasada. So the lamp becomes luminous by feeding it with the oil. And what is that oil? Bhakti. And what else? Prasada. The Bhakti that produces Prasada or Bhagavat Prasada or grace. That itself is the oil. So fed by this oil of devotion, this Jnana Deepam shines. Further, Mad Bhavana Abhiniveshita Vata Iritena. For the flame of knowledge to burn, you also need oxygen. So it cannot, the flame cannot survive in vacuum. So there is a slight flicker, there is a vatam which is required, which is an inspiration for this lamp. What is that vatam? That is Mad Bhavana Abhinivesha. The Abhinivesha or the intensity of meditation of the devotee towards Bhagavan. That is what is enhancing this knowledge or Viveka Pratyaya. And moreover, this Bhavana and Deepam also requires one more thing, which is the wick. Without wick, there is no flame or light possible. And what is that wick? Brahmacharyadi Sadhana Samskara Prajnavartina. So the wick here is Prajna. Prajna means a favorable impression. And that Prajna is induced by a sadhanam or an instrument or a discipline, which is Brahmacharyam. So the disciplines that are such as Brahmacharya helps the impressions such as Prajna awake in the Deepam. And that Deepam is what induces this lights up this Jnanam. And finally, Viraktandhakarana Adharena. The entire thing is kept in a receptacle. The whole Deepam is kept in a receptacle. That receptacle is Antahkaranam, one's own heart. So in that heart, Bhagavan lights this Jnana Deepam. That is the meaning of Nashayami Atma Bhavastha. One last thing he writes in the Bhashyam is Vishaya Vyavrutta Chitta Nivata Apavaragasthanena. Though little bit of oxygen is needed to for the survival of this flame, too much of wind can blow it off. So what is that wind? One's own likes and dislikes. If you are too obsessed, if there is obsession for things in your heart, that obsession can act as a huge obstacle for this knowledge to thrive. Hence, he says, it has to be, the mind has to be Vishaya Vyavrata, meaning it has to be withdrawn from other objects which you are not pursuing. So having withdrawn the senses from the objects, that is the meaning of Vishaya Avrata Chitta. And then that results in Raga Dvesha Akalushita. It removes that When the opposition is removed, all likes and dislikes are also removed. So, Vishaya Vyavritta Chitta Ragadvesha Kalushita Nivata Apavaraka Sthanena. So, placing in a place where there is no such disturbing factors such as this blowing wind in the form of likes and dislikes. In that state, Samyak Darshana Bhaswata, this Jnanam become Bhaswan. Bhaswa means very well lit. How? With Samyak Darshanam, with a brilliant proper vision or Jnanam. With Sat Jnana Deepam, I destroy the Mohandhakaram, the Ajnanam, the ignorance that is enveloping your proper vision. So that is the meaning of Tadanugrahat. So, He Saumya, Tvam, Vetha or Janasi, Tadanugrahat means Ishwaranugrahat. How do you understand? Tattvataha. Tattvataha means in reality. Yatarthena. And furthermore, one more thing you require for the unveiling of this knowledge. That is, Bruyuhu Snigdhasya Shikshasya. It has been unveiled by the Guru to the Shishya. And what is the qualification of the Shishya? He should be Snigdaha. Snigdaha means Premavataha. There has to be Preeti in the heart of Shishya. What is Preeti? Saranabuddhya Preetaha. When he has the power to accept unconditionally the teaching, then that attitude is called Snigdhata, or that softness, and he is ready for that knowledge. To such a student, the Guru would reveal this Rahasyam. Even in Ramayana, we find this instance very clearly. When Vishwamitra goes and makes a request to Dasharatha, it all appears as though Vishwamitra is suffering from this onslaught of these two demons. He says that in the 19th chapter, I think, of the Balakanda. Aham niyamam atishte siddhyartam purusharshabha tasya vignakaravudvotu rakshaso kamarupinau. Vishwamitra is telling to Dasharatha, I am trying to do some nishtha or a yaga, a kind of ritual, siddhyartham, for the success of the entire humanity. I am trying to do this. But tasya vigna karo dvo, there are two rakshasas or demons who are trying to inhibit or stop this kind of good actions. And how do they stop my vratam? He says, vrate me bohushas chirne samaptyam rakshasa vimau. Till the end of the yaga, they won't disturb my yajna. Then by the end, Marichaha Subahucha Viryavandu Sushikshitau. This Maricha and Subahu, who are Sushikshita, who are very well trained for stopping this ritual, they come and throw unnecessary obstacles in my altar. Thereby polluting my altar, they stop my yajnas. So now if Dasharatha thinks, why can't Vishwamitra, being a great powerful person, if he's a great guru, why can't he stop this
Ask.
Why can't these why can't Vishwamitra himself stop the obstacles that are arising from these two demons? So the question in the mind of Dasharatha was, if Subahu and Maricha are interfering with your Ajna, why can't Vishwamitra himself stop this mischief created by this Rakshasas? For that, Vishwamitra says, Nachame krodham utsrashtum buddhir bhavati parthiva tatha bodha hi sa charya na shapaha tatra muchyate. My charya, my action is such, because it is I am engaged in a great ritual, in the mid I should not let my anger loose, because if I am becoming angry, then my worship for these devatas will become affected. Hence, under such woes, such activity as cursing will be very inappropriate. As a result, he requests Rama to be spared by Dasharatha for this act of yajna. Suputram Rajasardula Ramam Satyaparakramam Kaka Pakshmadharam Shuram Jeshtam Me Datumarhasi. Among all your children, I want your eldest, because that Rama can really remove all the obstacles in my yajna. And don't think that I am really asking this Rama for my own personal selfish reason. Shreyaschasme pradasyami bahurupam nasamshayaha trayanamapi lokanam yena khyatmi gimshasi. I will also bestow a lot of learning in Rama, which will benefit him in the future. And as a result, he will also trayanamapi lokanam khyatmi gimshati, will attain fame in all the three worlds. And Vasishta also is in agreement with me. Vasishtopi Mahateja Echa Ime Tapasistida. Not only Vasishta, all the people who are assembled here, the sages, they also agree that only Rama can be of help in such a ritual. So Vishwamitra here is full of knowledge about Rama's who Rama is, that Rama is Paramapurusha, as the Veda says. Vedahametam Purusham Mahantam. So Vishwamitra knows that. As Krishna says, Mam Pasyati Sarvat Yomam Pasyati Sarvatra Sachamena Pranashyati. He who sees me everywhere, I am never lost to him. So Vishwamitra is always able to see Ishvara's presence everywhere. So he is able to see, recognize the true Swarupam of Rama. Hearing all this, Dasharatha is very worried, because he has gotten Rama after a long time, after doing this Putrakameshti, etc. So he is very silent, and Vishwamitra understands his attitude and he becomes very indignant by that. So immediately he tells, Ye idam te kshamam rajan gamishyami yathagatam. If you are not agreeable to my proposal, aham gamishyami, I will leave this place. Mithya pradijna kakutstha sukhi bhava suhurdvurtaha. Because you have these broken promises to keep, you can nonchalantly be happy with your family and you can continue to ignore me. At this point, Vasishta is worried about Vishwamitra being angry towards Raghuvamsha. Hence he interferes and tells Dasharatha this. Tesham nigrahane shakta swayam kushikatmajaha. Oh Dasharatha, don't think that Vishwamitra is incapable of destroying this Rakshasas. He is actually very capable of destroying them. Then why is he here? Tava putra hitarthaya twamipetya abhiyachate. He is trying to help Rama by giving all this knowledge. That is the reason why he is here, not for any selfish reason. And when Dasharatha hears this, tatha vasishte bhruvati racha Dasharatha swayam. Dasharatha himself go prahishta vadano ravam ajuhava salakshmanam. He brings Rama along with Lakshmana and hands them over to Vishwamitra. So as a result of this giving away of Rama to Vishwamitra, Rama is able to acquire all the mantras like Bala and Atibala and Astras and Shastras, which he is instructed by Vishwamitra. And not only the Astras, the Upasamhara Astras, the way you can not only inflict Astras on the opposite side, you can also do Upasamhara, meaning you can resolve them back. So if you have already decided to change course, you can actually remove them. So that is the reason why in the whole Ramayana, Vishwamitra does not appear again. Because his whole intent was to take Rama in the guise of asking protection for his yajna, but eventually he leads him to Janaka and makes him marry Sita, which is actually paving way to Ravana Nigraha in the future. So this way, the teachers are always thinking of the good of the students. The same thing here, when Parikshit approaches Shuka, Shuka also teaches him the Tattvam. And how he does is that, he says to Parikshit, Shuka says to Parikshit that, if you understand Advayam Tattvam, if you understand knowledge that is indivisible, then you also can see the serpent Takshaka, who is non-different from you, because he is also Atma Sarupa. Since Atma is one, there is no difference between Parikshit and the serpent. Once you understand the Tattvam, he can attain Mukti. Having given this Advayam Tattvam Jnanam, he suddenly disappears. That is what the Bhagavata itself says. Jagama Bhikshubhihi Sardham Naradevena, meaning by Parikshit Pujitaha. So, Guravaha, in other words, Guhyamapi, even though it is Rahasyam, Snigdhasya, to the submissive, to the humble student, Bruyuhu, or shall reveal all that is to be instructed. So that is the meaning of this verse, the 8th verse. And the next verse, the 9th verse is Tatra Tatranja Sayushman Bhavadayad Vinischitam Pumsam Ekantatasreyaha Tanasham Situmarhati. The Padacheda is Tatra Tatra Anjasa Ayushman Bhavata Yad Vinischitam Pumsam Ekantataha Sreyaha Tatu Na Shamsitum Arhasi. So Tatra Tatra means there, meaning all this knowledge is strewn in different places of the scriptures. That is why he is doing the Dvipsa, he is saying it twice. So those knowledge which you have gathered from different parts of scriptures, that is the meaning of Tatra Tatra. Anjasa. Anjasa means very easily. Easiness in what? Easiness in comprehending the inner meaning of the scriptures. Hey Ayushman, and you have also been blessed by the great sages. Bhavata, by you, yet vinischitam, whatever has been ascertained. So when people read scriptures, depending upon the maturity of the reader, all the things will be revealed. Since Shuka is the Veta of Ashtadash Puranas and all the Vedas and Vedangas, his reading of the scripture would be very different from other people reading it. That is why they are saying, whatever you are comprehending by your own background, that you tell us. For what? Pumsam ekantata shreyaha. Pumsam, for people, for us. Ekantataha, for the absolute. Shreyaha, for the good. Instead of prayaha, tat shamsitum arhasi, that we deserve to be taught. Here Sridhara writes, anjasa means grantha arjavena. So the word anjasa or easily means the power or capacity to comprehend the inner meaning of the granthas. That is called grantha arjavam. And what else he needs to teach them? Ekantataha shreyaha. Shreyaha, Sridhara writes, avyabhijari shreyas sadhanam. So sadhana means tool. Shreyaha means good. Why shreya is greater good? Because it is avyabhijari. It can unflinchingly take you to the goal. The other good would be prayaha, or the pleasant, which can give you tatkalika bahya indriya sukham. That is not what these rishis are seeking. They are actually seeking shreyaha, which is chirakalina kalyanakari, that which can really bestow the everlasting good. This is what the Upanishad also says. Shreyascha prayascha manushyametas tau samparitya vinivakti dhiraha. A dhiraha, or a thoughtful or a deliberate person, one who does not act mechanically, yetaha, these, manushyam, that which is approached by, prayaha shreyascha. So whenever a human experience happens, two possibilities or two choices arrive in front of him. One is good, Sreyaha, and the other is Preyaha. But the Dhiraha, Tau Samparitya, he turns away from what is pleasant and he always goes with Sreyaha, Abhipretya. Having analyzed, he goes after the good. So these rishis also, having understood the difference between what is pleasant, Preyaha, and what is Sreyaha, what is good, they are surrendering to Sudha and exclusively asking for providing with Sreyaha. So that is the meaning of this verse. Tatra tatra anjasa ayushman bhavata yadvinischitam pumsam ekantata Sreyaha tannashamsitum arhasi. Om swasti prajabhyah paripalayantam nyayena margena mahim mahisha gobrahmanebhyah shubhamastu nityam loka samasta sugino bhavantu sarve bhavantu suginaha sarve santu niramaya sarve bhadrani pasyantu ma kaschid dukkha bhag bhavet. Om shanti shanti shantihi.